You know, when you've been called.
Hello? We're going to get this order started. I know my U of L, UK people. What is that?
It just don't feel good.
Don't look the finger.
I mean, it's just downright uncomfortable.
Going to get started in a minute after this Fair Hammond song. We're talking about order today. Hallelujah.
Order.
play it. I just love this song. Yes, we talking about order today. And listen, before I can say this, the Lord has been talking to me about order for the past several months. My family household vision, the word is order in 2019. I've been walking around this house saying we got to get things in order. And one thing I want us to know is that no matter how intentional we are about living a life of order, sometimes that those unexpected things happen in life and take our attention away, and then we look up and think something's out of order. That is what's happened to me. And so we're getting things in order today. That word, 2019 order. And y'all know I'm all about acronyms, so you know there's an acronym for order. So before we get started, I want to welcome you all who are joining live. Go ahead and share this. And something seems out of order on the little thing. I just want to say a quick word of prayer, God. We know that you're going to speak through this Facebook Live about order. Order is in your word. Order is who you are. Order is your character. So, Lord, let us be who you want us to be in like-mindedness of who you are. So let us bring order to our life, even those things that are in order. We can always do a step further. So, God, speak now. Decrease me and increase your Holy Spirit. Amen. Hey, Miss Rhonda Percy. Order today. 2019 is my year of order. I'm sorry, y'all. That's what God has given me, order, O-R-D-E-R. And that is one of my favorite Fred Hammond songs, Your Steps Are Order. Oh my God, The Pages of Life. I forgot how much I love that CD. But in order for our steps to be ordered, we have to first realize that things are out of order. All right, and a lot, we are living in society. I just had a call with Miss Phyllis. We talked about that, how our society has allowed us to live out of order, and it's acceptable right now, especially for our younger generation. They don't have good manners anymore. Say yes, ma'am, no, ma'am. Respect level is gone. So a lot of things are out of order, and we can just look at 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue in DC and know that we are living in a world that is out of order. And so the Lord has spoken to me and said, Tanya, hey, Savaskia Pope, Miss Pope. Yes, she is the credit specialist. She, listen, you want things in order? Call Pastor Pope. She's going to get your credit together, because that's one thing we're going to talk about, getting things in order. Order. Before we get started, I want you to know that order for me, and this is what God gave me. Hi, Emery. Order stands for me, and I'm going to give it to you. Opportunities and results come through discipline, execution, and righteous living. Listen again. Order is opportunities, and results come through discipline, execution, and righteous living. So if you want those opportunities and all those results to come, you know, you say, I want to be a millionaire, I want to do this, I want to do that, I want to do everything God has told me to do. You have to be what? Disciplined. You got to execute God's plan in the order that he wants you to. And you got to be righteous in your living. And when I say righteous, it is not no super sanctified, spooky thing. Righteous living is just making the right choices and being moral and ethical in your decision making, in your habits, just from the little things. So righteous living is what we are called to live. Even if you're not a Christian, you are called to live righteous, because there is a right and a wrong way to live. All right. So order, remember, opportunities and results come through discipline, execution, and righteous living. So how do we get order in our lives to experience the benefits? Because these are the benefits of order: opportunities, results. And you're only going to experience those when you become disciplined, execute, and make right decisions. So I want you to think about, if you got a piece of paper, a notebook, a post-it note, jot down three things that you know specifically are in your life right now that are out of order. Three things. I'm going to tell you my three things. My finances, out of order. That's why I've been on a budget. Getting ready to call Pastor Pope about dealing with this credit situation. Even if you got good credit, you can always take it to the next level. My healthy living. I've got to get back on that gym grind and eating healthy to live. Not to lose weight, but to live. That's why I'm going to boot camp at Dewan Means on my birthday. That's my birthday gift to myself. 5 a.m. Lord have mercy. You know I must want things in order if I'm going to get up at 5 a.m. and go work out. So my health, my workout, my finances, and then just my physical environment. And when I say physical environment, I'm talking everything from my home, who I allow in my social circle, things that I do, decisions I make. Sometimes I know I need to be doing certain things and I procrastinate and go other places. That's out of order. So those are just three things in my life that I'm going to work on and get in order. If you want to share, put in the comments what things that you know are definitely out of order. All right? Yes, I can do it. Survive. I know I can. I can do all things. I'm going to get it in order. And one thing I know is because all of those things were in order. And like I said, sometimes things creep up. Life happens. And you look up and say, something's out of order. So what happened with me not eating healthy and being on my workout, my schedule got demanding at work. I was going, doing a lot of things and writing in my business. Those are not excuses. Those are just life. My sister and her son move in. And so we was adjusting to that. So I looked up. Things were out of order. I had not been eating right. I haven't been to the gym all 2018. Can you believe that? I looked, I said, Jesus, that's out of order. And then finances. Y'all know I love to pamper me some me. I love to go out to eat. And so I looked up, looking at my statements, spent a lot of time in restaurants, which contribute to my unhealthy eating and me getting off focus. A lot of time at the relaxer place. Although, you know, I love it. I have to be in order. I have to stop doing things that I want. So even though I make good money and there's an order. Order in your finances. And then my physical space. Everybody going to get an order in the White House. Everybody going to have a chore and consequences if they don't do it. And then just order in my social circle and thing I need to do. So those are some of the things. So what does order mean? Order can be a word that people don't like. When they say you need to get in order, they think they take offense to it. All right. Order in the court. Order in the court. I love me some law and order. I keep telling people I should have been a lawyer and I probably need to be a judge. But what does order mean? Here's the noun of what order means. And a command, direction, or instruction. The arrangement or disposition of people or things in relation to each other according to a particular sequence, pattern, or method. The verb definition of order, arrangement in a methodical or appropriate way. Everything in life has an order. Everything at your work has an order. Everything at church has an order. The Bible says, let's go to 1 Corinthians 14. This is where Paul is talking about pursuing love and spiritual gifts and setting the people in order in Corinth and giving certain order to how things happen in worship. But the last verse in 1 Corinthians 14, verse 40, and it talks about order in church meetings. He says, let all things be done decently and in what? O-R-D-E-R, order. So order is a certain pattern, a sequence, things, a command or instruction. God is a God of order. Even the way he created the earth, he created it in a certain order. He made sure that we had everything that we needed in the physical realm before he created man. Man came into a world that he had nothing that he ever needed but that rib. And then God, when he showed man and gave man and told him that he had dominion and power over all things, all the creatures, and that's when he said, now I'm going to bring you a helpmeet, your rib. So there is an order even to God's creation. So what are some things? Let's talk about this real quick, because I know we are U of L, UK focused. Let me do my L's up, because U of L has all my money. I have many degrees from U of L, so even though I don't watch basketball, U of L. All right, so order. Remember, opportunities and results come through discipline, execution, and righteous living. We already identified those things that are order deficits in your life. How are you going to correct them? So let's talk about my healthy living and workout. I've already come up and made a schedule. And mine is going to be one of sacrifice, because 5 a.m., I know I'm going to have to push myself. And I know in the past, when I do early morning workouts, that sets the tone for my day in terms of eating, in terms of my mindset, in terms of my energy. And so I've already made a schedule for the 6 weeks in Dewan Means, by any means fitness, is starting a boot camp on my birthday, the global holiday, which is Tanya White Day, Monday, December 31st. And he has three options. So I was like, okay, what better birthday gift to give myself than start working out? And so I've made a schedule. I've committed to going to the boot camp, because it's going to be a sacrifice. 5 o'clock. That means I got to wake up at 4, get ready, drink a protein drink or something, and get ready to work out and give it my all. So that's how I've set to correct it. And then once I get there, I'm going to have to do what he tells me to do. First, I'm going to sacrifice getting up and being there at 5:30 a.m. Sacrifice financially. That's an investment in myself. And then if I'm doing those two things, I've got to follow what? The order of eating and the order of working out when I'm not in his presence. So that's how I'm going to correct the order deficit in my life of getting back of unhealthy eating and working out. So when you identify those things that I told you to, those three things, now you have identified them, put how you're going to correct them. If it's finances, getting your credit in order. Listen, Pastor Savosky Pope's on here. She's a credit specialist. She can help you. She's posted her number in the comment section. Get with her. I know when it comes to our finances, that's a little hidden little secret we don't want to deal with when people are trying to tell us what to do with our money. But if you want to experience what the opportunities, the results that God has told you that he's already got in store for you, but he can't give it to you because you're out of order, get yourself in order through knowing that these opportunities and results are possible when you are disciplined, when you execute a plan, and when you make the right decisions. All right? Order. All right? So what are the overall benefits of increasing order in your life? You're going to experience success. When you get things in order in one area, it's a domino effect in other areas. So for instance, let's go back to me eating healthy. I'm going to eat healthy. That means I've got to go shopping. I can't eat processed food. I can't eat all those packaged foods. I have to eat healthy and follow the menu that Dewan gives me. So it's going to be a sacrifice. So I got a meal plan. And so what happens is I'm going to save more money, even though it may not look like it first. I am going to save more money because I am preparing my meals at home. So not only is it a health benefit, it's going to benefit my finances. That's going to another goal I wanted to do. And then it's going to benefit my decision-making process, because when I eat healthy, my mind is clear. I'm working out. So my overall attitude is affected. So when my attitude is in a positive way, and they say when working out gives you a positive adrenaline, endorphins kick in. And so that affects, okay, I'm getting healthier physically, mentally. It's going to affect how I perform on my job. You know, I think I do a great job. I can only go higher. It's going to impact my business because I'm going to be thinking. I'm going to have all this energy. And then impact my decisions because now, because I'm on this schedule, going to boot camp at 5:30 a.m., then I have to go to bed, set a time. I can't watch TV. I can't watch all this. You know, I love, you know, me some TV, but I have to set order in my life. All right. So that's how it affects. The overall benefit is a domino effect. It affects every area in life. When you work on one thing to get order in your life, it's going to automatically have a positive domino effect because you're going to make better intentional decisions because you are focusing on order in your life. So we've identified and have, and told you how to correct the order deficit in your life. Understand the overall benefits. It's a domino effect. When you get order in one area, everything comes to play. Hi, Miss Dr. Shama. And let's realize that order decreases distractions. Now, one of the things I told you, the White House, I'm having a vision night tonight. I've been talking about it for about a month. We're going to set order in the house. Everybody's going to have specific chores and consequences when they don't do their chores. When you get your physical environment in order, then you will be less distracted mentally and emotionally. Trust me. Your physical space and environment does impact your emotional and mental state. All right? When you are ordered, say, one of my, I'm sorry, y'all. I always scratch my nose. But another area I told you is I'm working on a social, bringing order to my social circle. There's some decisions and some boundaries that I'm making more on the front end of me connecting with people. Now, I'm cordial to everybody, of course. I love people. I love empowering people. But there are certain decisions and things that I need to make that are tighter and more aligned in order with where God wants to take me that I have to be intentional about. So when I make those decisions and I'm making a list, what I want people to get from me and what I want to add to their life and what I expect. And so, hey, Miss Dottie Pivot, I love, love, love your gathering. Listen, we're going to talk. I've already seen some things. I need to connect with you. But life's distractions. So when I'm bringing order to my social life, there's no more dividing of who I am. Yes, ma'am. Okay, yes, Sebastian, I'm going to talk to you too. There's no more division or turn away when I bring order to what I expect from my people I allow my social circle to connect with. Now, I'm cordial with everybody, but there's a difference of being connected. There is not a division, not only of other relationships, but an internal division of who I am and what I'm supposed to do. Because when we connect with people who are not on the same page of where God is wanting to take us and not speaking the same life language that God has given us, I've learned that too. My life language right now is, yes, I am enough. And I am telling everybody, you are enough. You are good enough. You are powerful enough. You are skilled enough. You are magnetically phenomenal. And so I need to be connected with people who are talking those same verbiage, who believe that they are enough. They believe that they have, they are fearfully and wonderfully made. I'm talking about people I connect with who I let pour into me and coach and give me and pray for me. We need to be talking the same language. And so now I've picked up and I'm bringing order to my social connections, what I can give to them, what I expect to receive from them. And if it's not, it's just like any other relationship. It's a deal breaker. So I'm doing my research, being prayerful and discerning before I connect with anybody. That's how I'm bringing order to my social connections. All right. And so therefore, when I bring order to my life, it decreases the distractions. Hey, Miss Felicia, decreases the division, thereby decreasing the delays in my life. Lord have mercy. When I look back over my life and see how I was connected with people in my inner circle that were not talking my same life language, it delayed me. Why? Because I then questioned who I was, and I was trying to pour into them so they could see me. Please see me the way God sees me. Please know, Lord have mercy, I wasted time. So it delayed who I am. See, I'm supposed to be right now. Me and Oprah supposed to be helping her with some things, okay? In my mind, but I because I didn't know who I was. I didn't know that I was enough. And so when you don't know that you're enough, you connect with other people and you leech onto people to try to validate who you are when God's already validated you. So it distracts you. When you're out of order, there's distractions that come, divisions, and delays. And when all that happens, if you're an entrepreneur, that impacts your bottom line. Because this is one thing I tell people. Listen, this is a Tanya-ism. People lead and do business the way they live. Ow! Listen, you cannot separate who you are and what you do. I don't care. We put on masks and everything. Eventually, that mask is going to melt. And people are going to see you for who you are. All right? So I tell people all the time. I tell my babies in my student leadership club. You lead the way you live. You respond the way you live, okay? So, listen. Get in order. So, if you're always late, if you don't follow up with people, if you're not adding anything to the connection, if you're always doing things out of vain conceit and always me, trust me, people are not going to want to do business with you. Dr. Katz told me and reiterated to me this year, people do business with who they what? No. Like and trust. I don't care if you are an author and have a book. I don't care if you got a business. I don't care if you are whatever you do. People are not going to connect with you unless they know you, like you, and trust you. How do they do that? It's because of how you live. Let me tell you something. You can do things on the down low and be secret all you want to. Your secrets will find you out. Ain't that what the old people say? My grandma used to say, you're smelling your must. So I know you're doing something out of order. So, listen, live the way you want to live according to God's standard. If you want success, you got to live a successful life. If you want people to know who you are, you've got to make yourself friendly, approachable, and you have to have a brand. We're talking about branding in some of my other groups. But your brand is your lifestyle. You can't create something that you're not. Beyoncé is Beyoncé because she's always been Beyoncé since Beyoncé was a baby. Trust me when I tell you. I've seen her. I'm a Beyoncé follower. Not much like my sister-in-law. But Beyoncé has been Beyoncé. She said when she was in Destiny's Child, I am going to be a millionaire by the time I'm 30, and I'm going to have my own solo. So she did everything she was supposed to do. Why? Because she already lived where she wanted. Where she is now, she's been living in her mind all since she was a little baby on Star Search. So if you want order in your life, hi, Curl Peace, you got to live in order. And what is order from Tanya's perspective? Order brings opportunity and results through discipline, execution, and righteous living. All right? So, order in the court. Order in your life. Bring order. Identify those areas that are order deficits in your life and correct them. Work on one or two. And trust me, when you work on one or two, it's going to be a domino effect. All right? Understand that there are positive overall benefits of bringing order to one area in your life. Because it's going to saturate all areas. When you working intentionally and really focused on order, bringing it into your life, order, opportunities and results, it's going to come through discipline, execution, and righteous living. All right? And realize that order, being out of order, only increases your distractions, your divisions, your delays. But once you're in order, it decreases them. And also, when you're in order, it's going to increase your opportunities that you have in business because people are going to know you, like you, And most of all, trust you. So they're going to connect with you and want to do business with you, want to buy your product, want to come to your plays, want to buy your CDs. They're going to come to your workshops. They're going to come to your events, do your webinars when you get order. All right? Listen, I told you I was going to be done by 1:35. It's 1:31. Order in the court. Order in the court. Bring order to your life. Get those opportunities and results that God wants you to have in 2019 and beyond. But in order to do that, remember, you're going to have to be disciplined. You're going to have to execute God's plans in His order, in His timing, and make the right decisions. Live a life of ethical and moral uprightness. You don't have to be a Christian to be ethical and morally right. Make the right decisions. Treat people with love, kindness, respect. All right? I'm so tired of these jealous, intimidating people that create havoc for other people. And I'm going to stop right there because then I'm going to get on a tangent that's out of order. Love you guys. Listen, y'all know tomorrow begins my Golden Cupcakes birthday. Then Monday is the global holiday, which is Tanya White Day. I will be 48, and 48 is going to be beyond great. So I love your support. I respect it. I love how you've supported me thus far, been mentors from afar, mentors in hand. And I look forward to 2019. Yes, I Am Enough Nation is going to rise up. More things to come from Tanya White. So much order in my life. Y'all going to see it because I'm going to have opportunities and results, all right? And it's all going to come from being disciplined, executing the plan God had for my life, and making the right decisions. Love you guys. Enjoy the game. Bye-bye.